touching gloves in the center of the circle.
Intense focus shown on the faces of both these women.
Yeah, it was noticeable immediately, wasn't it? Look at Jenny Huang, crouched in that position, quite square on. Really focused.
It's brawl right away by Jenny Huang.
Yamaguchi looks a more relaxed of the two, sends in a little right hand that clips Jenny Huang's jaw. Jenny goes for the kick to the thigh.
That's what Yamaguchi does so well. She sets up her takedown with those punches. Steps in with the right hand, ducks under, hits a left hook, hits some level changes, makes Jenny Huang think.
She thinks that Jenny Huang overcommits with her left hook, and she's looking to counter that. So watch out for it. Really quite square on from the waist up, Jenny.
Yeah, Jenny Huang employing an interesting stance here.
I haven't really seen that from her too much before. Remember those Muay Thai contests that she's had this year may have changed things for her.
She's had 5 this year. Does a lot for your confidence, being in there, putting in the time, the hours, your stand-up, getting those rounds in.
Leading with that right hand, she's got Mei on the wall of the circle. Oh, the right hand from Mei Yamaguchi was solid, and it sent Jenny back a step. She looks all right. But that reminded her who she's in the circle with. Mei catches that right kick. And we're the jump of a distinct possibility here, Gianni.
And yeah, it's okay. Now Yamaguchi's got both hooks in. This is a more dangerous position. Huang in trouble early in the round.
Managed to go belly to belly. Mei is stuck underneath that right arm.
Oh, May's gonna transition to back. We got a sparkle here. A gift wrap position, excuse me. You see her hand holding on to Jenny Huang's hand.
Halfway through this opening round. This crowd really are getting into this. They love Mei. Mei Yamaguchi, she's a big star here. Her personality is a big aspect of that. Look at that welt on the left thigh of Mei.
Yeah, those two kicks landed early for Huang. Those are what caused the welts on Yamaguchi's leg.
She's running out of options to perform those for the moment with her back to the canvas. And Mei looking to unload with a little bit of ground and pound.
Huang trying to wrap up the arms of Yamaguchi, possibly looking for an armbar submission. Yamaguchi, a black belt judo and Brazilian jiu-jitsu herself.
Mei just driving her forward, sliding her opponent on her back along the circle, sending in those right thudding hammer blows to the nose. Jenny looks very focused indeed. She has to be at the moment. Got the feet on the hips, pushing Mei back. Mei holds on to that ankle to see what she can do, push it aside hopefully, and then come down with some punches. That's what she's aiming for. From her back, pulling her opponent in, cuffing her around the ear with that right hand, using the elbow as well. It's good work from Jenny on her back, Jim.
Good work from Jenny. Jenny is really dangerous off her back. She's got a go-go-go plot of submission off her back. That's why I nicknamed Lady Go-Go. But I doubt she'll be able to land that on Yamaguchi, who's a veteran grappler herself.
Well, Yamaguchi's hair decidedly disheveled after the haranguing that she's been getting from Jenny, with her head down, pulled in towards her. Oh, good blows from Jenny again from her back, doing really good work with the strikes. Mei Yamaguchi had to adjust there because she was just taking barefaced blows from her opponent. This is more difficult for Mei Yamaguchi than a lot of people figured it might be, I think.
Yamaguchi staying active, landing those short shots. Wants the guard of Huang to open up so she can pass, but taking her time here.
Deep dive into Muay Thai and striking generally from Jenny Huang, and eating more so that she can be stronger and be more suitable at the weight. Seems early on to be paying some dividends for Jenny. She's much able to handle a woman of this size. Pulling her in. Running out of time for Mei Yamaguchi to advance from this position in the first round. And really, when you consider that it's Jenny on the bottom here, she is the one pulling out the more effective strikes for the last what, 90 seconds or so.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. Jenny Huang doing work off the bottom all round. You see her controlling the left arm to Yamaguchi and rattling off some strikes with her right hand. So good control of the arms are throwing off her strikes as well. Yamaguchi was able to land a couple shots of her own, but it's been Jenny Huang who's been more active with the strikes.
What a showcase of how to be aggressive from the base. Now, I mentioned Mei's hair. It's not ideal, is it, that between rounds she has to focus on that rather than listening to her cornerman, getting some ice, getting some liquids down. But there we are.
Jenny Huang takes a deep, deep breath.
What a performance that was from Jenny, and I'm not sure how much more of that Mei wants. She may try and attempt another road towards victory, because jumping on top of her opponent, hoping to perform some ground and pound or some submissions, wasn't working out for her in that first 5 minutes. Two rounds to come here if we go the distance. Judges will score on the contest in its entirety. They won't split it up round by round. This is the second stanza. Jenny again, hyper-focused with those eyes wide open. Mei breathing quite hard. Early in the second round, she eats a right hand from Jenny Huang.
I can see Jenny go back to those low kicks. She hit two early in the first round, caused those welts.
She's looking for it there. I think Mei just pulled out of range. Two women exchange left jabs, both of which landed. Jenny Huang open mouth, but I don't think it's because she's struggling with cardio. It's just the intense focus, concentration on her opponent. Some athletes like to look at their opponent's chest, maybe to get a sort of central perspective on where they are. But Jenny's looking deep into the eyes of Mei Yamaguchi.
That's a good strategy here to employ the reach advantage that he has. Keep her range with the jabs and throw those low kicks. She knows Yamaguchi needs to get past her range to land her shots.
She's targeting the outside of that left thigh. There it is again, Gianni. It's going to be even redder in a few seconds than it was when we were looking in the first round. And I wonder if that's bothering Mei as she scoots over to her right-hand side. She gets caught with the left hand. Oh, and Mei sends a nice little right hand and then takes the single leg. And we're back to where we were in the first round.
Good work by Mei to close the distance with feints and establish another takedown and top control.
And Mei has to consider working to improve her position from here, because I think, in terms of just strikes from this position, in the first round, she got outpointed.
I agree with you, Steve. Yamaguchi needs to look to pass, get past the close guard of Huang, maybe past the side control. Establish a more dominant position and look for submissions or hard strikes of her own.
Oh, Jenny slips out of that. Didn't quite manage to come away completely. Left a leg in there, but she got away ultimately, and they're back on their feet.
Jenny Huang is looking good tonight. She's showcasing that new and improved striking, and a couple takedown attempts, a couple takedown get-ups as well.
And up against the very high-level opponent, this might just be, Gianni, the best we've seen of her.
This might just be. She's eating up the leg of Yamaguchi right now, backing her up.
Right and left from Jenny. Then she got a little bit carried away, and the ease with which Mei just backed off and out of range of those punches was a little bit comical, actually. All right hand from Mei, and it landed nicely. Right on the nose. In comes Jenny, though, with aggressive kicks there, targeting the lower leg that time. And that welt on Mei Yamaguchi's left thigh looks worse and worse. And I wonder how long she'll be able to put the vast amount of her of balance on that leg, because you look at her stance, she leans on that left leg more than the right leg, which is behind her. Goes for the double leg, gets it.
Beautiful entry by Yamaguchi, and another takedown. Let's see if she's able to score off it, though. This is the second takedown of the second round. She wasn't able to score off the first one.
And again, it's Jenny who's doing the better work from her back. We've only seen a few seconds of it, but she's the one throwing punches.
Jenny Huang gets her back in the closed guard.
Mei's punches just stopped in the tracks, aren't they? She's doing so well, Jenny, pinning her opponent's fists to her chest. And then when they do escape, it's Jenny who has the quicker hands and gets those punches in first.
Yeah, Yamaguchi needs to look to pass here. These short shots from the guard is not enough. Jenny Huang She's too busy off her back.
Just about 9 minutes down, Gianni. That means six to go. Yamaguchi's going to pull this one out of the bag. Looking to try and improve that position as they get to grips with each other, but Jenny's back on her feet.
Good job by Jenny Huang to work back up to her feet, but eats a big knee by Yamaguchi for her work.
Doesn't look the stronger of the two, Jenny, does she? She says she's small for the weight. We know she's improved her diet to try and compensate for that, but she's showing us that she has strength.
Huang's coming in with something to prove tonight.
Inside the final half minute of this second stanza then. Jenny now in the orthodox position, but she's very square on from the waist up.
That one hurt her, Steve, I think. Yamaguchi's now diving for the legs.
Nice right hand as they came apart there from Jenny, who's breathing hard and still looking with intense concentration at her opponent. Oh, she throws a big right hand. Reminds me of the one that she landed on the face of Angela Lee in their first contest, but that one wasn't nearly as effective. My goodness me, what a round that was, what a contest this is. Who did you guys at home predict would win this one? You can let us know on the ONE Super app. Play the fantasy game, compare your predictions with your friends, have a little contest with them, see how you go. It's available on the App Store and Google Play. Download that ONE Super app and play ONE Fantasy. Great way to get involved. Again, Mei has to mess with her hair. I know this might seem inconsequential, but really, there are better ways to spend the 1 minute rest that you have.
Steve, Jenny Huang is pulling away in this bout. She's showcasing that improved stand-up, chopping at the legs of Yamaguchi. Yamaguchi landed two takedowns, but wasn't able to land anything significant. She needs a big third round here.
Gulps down the water, 5 minutes to come. If you had to judge it now, Gianni, who are you going for?
I'd have to give it to Jenny Huang based on those low kicks and her work rate. She's been able to land, get off more shots than Yamaguchi.
I'm with you. Mei has to turn this around if she's going to win it. She's got less than 5 minutes. Look at that concentration again. Jenny Huang eats her right hand. Mei Yamaguchi has to get to work.
It just really goes to show you how if you take the time off to work on the holds of your game, it can help you so much.
What a story this would be for Jenny. Won her first five contests at ONE Championship, as a professional, and then lost her next four. Yamaguchi was one of the people that beat her. Angela Lee also amongst them. Gina Inyong another.
This would be a huge upset if she's able to pull off this victory tonight.
It would entirely change the course of her career, and she could quite rightfully ask for a shot, quite legitimately, at a championship belt.
Oh, right hand left hook.
Mei had to back off a little bit there, and she's taken one or two blows, and she backs up again. And I think Mei's slightly hurt. She's moving sideways, she's moving backwards, she's not looking to engage so much.
Huang has landed two left hooks that wobbled Yamaguchi a little bit.
And she looks the fresher of the two as well. She's got much better movement at the moment.
And Huang's got Yamaguchi hesitant now.
Mei needs time to recover. She's had that space, that moment, just to get herself together. She's got 3.5 minutes to turn this one around. Trips her opponent by grabbing the single leg.
Don't count Yamaguchi out. One submission is all it takes to end this bout, and Yamaguchi has all the tools to do just that.
She's done it before, hasn't she, Gianni, against this opponent? So she knows she can, but at the moment, submission defense is at a premium. And Jenny Huang seems to have it in spades.
For the first time, Yamaguchi is able to get past the guard of Jenny Huang. She's in half guard right now, needs to advance the position. She's got 3 minutes left in the third and final round.
Mei tries to move up.
Gonna slide through and pass the side control now.
She's got side control. What can she do with it? Fists to the side of the head.
So you're trying to isolate the left arm with Jenny Huang.
Well, that's what she needs to do, because Jenny's been so successful from her back. And if she can control those hands and then slip in her own punches, she will turn things around. But will she be able to do it significantly enough? The judges are watching. Leg of Mei's been absolutely battered, hasn't it?
She's
got that arm sorted out. She's this that crucifix position you like to speak about a lot, Gianni?
Yeah, this is a crucifix position, a terrible position for Huang to be in. 2 minutes left, but no, Huang pops that arm out.
A little bit of respite for her to have that right arm free once again. And that knee came in, but it was blocked by that right arm. And knee again from Mei, and this time she's got a clean shot.
Crowd getting behind the hometown hero.
They really are, less than 2 minutes to go. She needs all the help she can get, Mei Yamaguchi. And Jenny from her back sends in some punches again and elbows, right and left from her. About 10 punches unanswered. All the while, Mei looking to improve position and climb up the body of her opponent to gain total control.
And sit
nice and high up on that body. A lot of energy expended.
No back on the head.
Final 80 seconds, Gianni. It's all important.
Yamaguchi tried to pass, but Huang pushed her knee back down into half guard.
What a contest this has been. And are we about to see what would be quite a surprise? Hammer blows from Mei Yamaguchi and they hurt. Driving her opponent into the wall of the circle.
Oh, wow. Huang gets back up.
What an effort from this woman. She's shown us what she hasn't managed to show us before. Position.
Huang came in prepared tonight.
This crowd making huge noise all around this venue.
Huang now pushing Yamaguchi against the cage.
Elbow from Huang. Caught Mei flush on the nose. Inside the last half minute, Mei digs in a couple of right hands. Ineffective though.
Mei needs something big here in the last 20 seconds.
What a battle this has been, what an effort from both women. Digging to the body and misses as she pulls away, Mei Yamaguchi. Still light on her feet, but that's not going to be enough. The swinging back fist wasn't effective at all. And Jenny Huang counters with a right hand. She finishes the bout with a right to the jaw. And for my money, Gianni, Jenny Huang has stolen this from the Japanese woman in front of a crowd who desperately wanted her to win.
Wow. Yamaguchi landed multiple takedowns in this bout, but it was Jenny Huang with her kicks and her improved striking and takedown get-ups. I feel like she took this bout away from Yamaguchi, Steve.
I think we've never seen anything quite like this from Jenny Huang before. She's always impressed. She's always showed us that she's there or thereabouts. But she didn't really demonstrate that she had that significant step up in her game to successfully challenge for a world title. And she is putting herself into that position today. She needs the confirmation of the judges. And I suspect we're about to get that. Here's Dominic Lau, and he's got the magic numbers on a card in his hand. The decision coming now.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have called this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Mei Yamaguchi.
Tokyo, I am here with your winner, Mei Yamaguchi. Impressive performance here tonight in the rematch. How do you feel about getting a huge victory at One Century?
Yeah, I'm so excited, but I didn't want to finish with the decision, so I have to do harder. But one thing I want to say that, Mr. Chaudhry, may I challenge the belt now? Come on. お越しいただいて皆さんありがとうございました。判定じゃなくて1本でフィニッシュしたかったんですけども、ちょっと力が及ばずすいません。ただ勝ったことでチャトリさんにお願いがあります。後向きの大 タイトル挑戦させてください。
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Mei Yamaguchi!